dip me underway. You can kill me on my first flow, flow, flow. Hold me till I scream for air breeze. And wash me over until my will runs dry. Send all your sins all over me, baby, baby, baby. What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to run some errands and I am also going to get my hair done. I'm excited for that. I'm getting knotless braids, jumbo butt length. So right now I have to go and drop off a package. I sold something on Depop, sold some shoes, so I'm going to go and drop those off. So I'm bringing you guys along with me. Okay guys, I know I did not take you along the way to get my hair done. I wish I did. I dropped off my package, but my hair is done. It's not the best lighting. I'm probably gonna show you guys better when I get inside the house, but it's butt length. But my hair is finished. I love it so much. This girl did my hair in less than 2 hours and I freaking love it. She was so sweet. Oh, she's so cute. I'm gonna put her credentials or her Instagram or somewhere on the screen, but it's so cute. I really hope I can upkeep these edges because I'm not the best with edges. Sometimes I am, sometimes I'm not, but I did say I wanted edges out because I think edges make like the braids just look so much better. I am so excited and I love it. And she did under 2 hours and I'm so excited because I'm freaking done. I didn't have to wait, but this is just so good and the price is good. I got butt length, so it was an extra $20, but for this length, it's jumbo. But she had such a good vibe. I'm gonna put her information. If anybody's looking for a Queens braider, go to her, check her out. I'm going to be doing like my toes, my nails. So this is basically gonna be like a maintenance week. So I'm about to go home and then eat something cause I'm starving. And then you guys will see like if I do my nails, eyebrows, eyelashes maybe, and then like toes and everything. But yeah, here's my hair. What is up, you guys? So I know that I was gonna show you guys me getting my hair done. I did not film that. I foolishly freaking forgot. I was really caught up in just getting my hair done and talking with the hairstylist, and I wanted to show you guys just what I do for my weekly maintenance, just like for my little, you know, my eyebrows, my nails, toes. What I need to do next is my eyebrows, eyelashes, my nails. My nails definitely need a fill-in. I need my nails done and my toes. So what I'm gonna do first is my eyebrows, eyelashes, and I also want to show you guys like my skincare. I want to show you guys just what I do to wash my face and do like maybe a face mask, maybe not. I don't know if I really feel like doing a face mask, but I'm gonna show you guys how I like shave my face so that like when I do makeup for work in the morning, it's like, you know, smooth. Right now I'm gonna show you guys just how I do my eyebrows, but let me know down in the comments if you love this hairstyle because I do. It's so cute. I want to show you guys because it's like, it's really long. It's like booty length, booty length, booty length. But right now I'm gonna show you guys just how I do my eyebrows. I'm literally just going to be cleaning up my eyebrows because I had just got it done, but I'm gonna show you guys that it's more of like a DIY weekly maintenance. I do wax my own armpits, but I don't need one right now. It's not a lot of hair, so maybe the next weekly maintenance vlog that I do, I'll show you guys. But I literally just use a tweezer, but it's a Revlon tweezer, really good. Got it from Walgreens. I literally just tweeze my eyebrows. Beauty is pain, beauty is pain. Once I start doing my eyelashes, I think that's more the interesting part. Yeah, I missed you guys. I'm filming. I feel so good. It's so like, I don't know, I just miss filming. And it just, I feel like I'm in my element when I film. And I hope I have one on here. I do. I don't tweeze the top of my eyebrows. And I'm happy that I got my eyebrows done at a place because I go to the mall and get it done. Because if I don't, you know, I wouldn't have like a good foundation just to like pluck. Because right now I'm just doing like a maintenance cleanup on my eyebrows. The stragglers. Because I got my eyebrows done probably 2 weeks ago. And they're like still looking like I got them done. But you know, I need the maintenance. I like it when my eyebrows are like clean. And then I just shave the top because I don't like doing the, I don't like plucking the top because at the, for some reason at the top of my eyebrows, it's always like really just peach fuzz. My sister is gonna come in my room. Come in. Hi, you look cute. Alexandra's going on a date. Must be nice. I'm gonna do my other eyebrow and then I'm gonna move on to my eyelashes. I do love getting my nails, eyebrows, toes done and everything, but it's not always in the budget. It gets really expensive. My eyebrows are finito. Now I'm going to do my pressed 3D white strips, and I've been doing them not every day but every other day because my teeth be sensitive. One thing about teeth sensitivity, that shit is like, is no joke. So I'm gonna take this out, one of them, almost done. The strip, this one's the enamel safe one. The enamel safe one is pretty good for me. I had gotten my teeth whitened before and it really like, I was going through it. Cause when you whiten your teeth, you open up the pores in your teeth and it's like open. So and your teeth get really, really sensitive. It's just overly sensitive and like wind, whatever, if you touch your teeth, it bothers it. So when I got my teeth whitened professionally, like one time a while ago, it really bothered my teeth. So I got the enamel safe one, it's not bad. The first time I used it, I did like feel something, but as I kept going, doing it, it's fine now. But what I'm doing, I'm taking a cotton round, a clean cotton round, and wiping my teeth so that it is, you know, just dry and it can stick. Because when it's like wet and you got saliva, it's like, it doesn't stick as well. So I'm hurrying up, trying not to touch my teeth. And I'm putting, I just touch my teeth. That's another thing I do for maintenance, and obviously I didn't think this through because now I'm gonna be talking a little weird for 30 minutes. But yeah, that's another maintenance thing I do. Just to, I'm trying to really just whiten my teeth because I've had like yellower teeth. I'm older, I have money to like get whitening or get the whitening strips, and I'm trying to like, I don't know, just take better care of my teeth and try to enhance my appearance. And then now I'm gonna put a timer for 30 minutes. Well, I'm putting a timer for 30 minutes and we are going to do my eyelashes. So I do my own eyelashes because y'all know eyelash techs, all them people charging you 100 plus, 80 plus, 60 plus. I've gotten my eyelashes done before for like birthdays and like special occasions, but they're never like how I want it. And it's just like, I'm paying this money and I don't like the outcome. When I got my eyelashes done one time, the girl had taken my bottom lashes. She ripped my bottom lashes out and I started crying. I was like, okay, I'm not, that was the last time. I was like, I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this again. I've got a couple things here that I've bought from Amazon. I bought like an eyelash kit, just stuff to get my eyelashes, do them at home, and for them to look professionally. Now I'm not gonna sit here and say that it lasts for me. Now they last me a week, maybe 2 weeks when I do these steps. So I did my lashes last week, so I'm gonna show you guys what I use. But I use like the individual, but the clusters. I don't use the individuals because I'm not, no, I just think this a lot. I can't get with it. It's just very hard for you to get. I just bought this lash serum that I put, that's gonna be the first thing I put on. And I just brush it. I'm brushing it on my bottom lash because I want those to be full too. Alexandra has a lash serum that she bought. Alexandra, my sister. Anytime I go in her room, I just be like, let me put that on too. That's the first step that I'll do. Next thing I use, or I'm gonna use, I got the kit. I think this is the Kiss kit. Who's texting my phone? And then I go in with the Bond. I'm gonna look down here. How I do it is I don't put it on the full lash, or I try not to. When I was putting it on the full lash or putting a lot, it just came off. Now I got one of these little things, and what I do is I use a lash glue. This is a mega hold individual eyelash glue, and I think this is the Kiss one. This ain't no sponsored shit, so if you guys want, ask me in the comments and I'll I'll definitely get back to you and answer you where I got the stuff and send you a direct link, but I'm not linking this stuff. She's not a sponsored girl yet. I am going to use, I use lash glue and the bond, and that's what makes it last longer for me. And I also don't put the whole bond everywhere. And then what I do is, this is not really a tutorial, but it kind of is, making it like a tutorial. I don't dip the whole thing, only a little bit, but I dip a little bit and then I need to use this. I need to use my little mirror. And then I put it at the bottom of my lashes. And there you go. There's a lot of like tutorials on TikTok that show you what you gotta do, but I'm only gonna put two. Like I said before, I had already had a lash set in, and I am using 10 millimeter and 8 millimeter lashes, because another thing that I have learned when using lashes, the longer you use or the longer length, the harder it is to stay on for me. Because listen, I like to wash my face, and when you use longer lashes, they don't last because you're using like water. So I use the smaller ones because they definitely last longer for me. We love that. We love when you know, our DIY stuff lasts long and looks good. I've had these on for a good week now. They blasted me, so I let it get tacky for a little bit and then put it on. I'm sorry I'm not like giving you guys the best close-up of what I'm doing, but I just put it on under my eye, dab it. Now, going on to the next one. Oh, and I'm using this type of tweezer, the tweezer with the curve. And then now I'm gonna do the next lashes. And like I said, I'm using 10 millimeter and an 8 millimeter.
And yeah, that's how I do my lash maintenance.
All the stuff that I have can be found on Amazon. You could literally find a kit for like $20 and use that. But yeah, I love doing this maintenance stuff because it's just like, for me it's self-care, you know, because you love the outcome. I love just like either watching YouTube or, I don't know, watching a show. I've been watching Love Island. But I love self-care. Sometimes it can be work, and sometimes I do not do this all the time. I don't do this all the time. I don't. If I'm not in the mood, I don't do it. I'm being realistic. But if I feel like doing it, this is what I'm doing. And if I don't have the money to do, like, you know, go get everything done, I'm doing the DIY, girls. I'm doing the DIY because you save so much money. Don't get me wrong, I love it when I go get my stuff done, but you'll save a coin. You'll save some coins. I'm here for saving a coin here and there. I'm done with that. I only put two on this one. But what I do next is I clump them together just to make sure, you know, they are secure. And remember, I said I put the eyelashes under, not over. But yes, so I did my eyelashes. And, well, you know, they have the seal. My lashes do last. This will probably last me a full work week, and I won't have to do it till next Sunday or Friday. That's pretty much it. They last for a week. I'm not going to tell you that they last forever, but they do last. But I also have, like, a fan. Cute little fan. It came with the kit. Just putting my stuff back. Then finished. You know, this is nice. That's enough. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you guys how, like, I shave my face. But yeah, I'm going to show you guys how I wash my face, and I'll just shave the little peach fuzz off my face, and then I'm going to start with my nails and toes. I think that's the best part. So, let's go. Alright guys, so I am in my bathroom. Sorry if it sounds a little different, but I am going to show you guys how I dermaplane, I don't know, my face. But first, I'm going to show you guys what I use. So, I recently picked this up in Target. I needed a double cleanser because I ran out of mine. But I picked this up in Target for $5. It was a mini cleanser, and I'm very excited to use it because it has niacinamide, hyaluronic acid, and vitamin C. And I use all three serums, so it's just been treating my face beautifully. After I use this first as a cleanser, but I also just, when I put this on, I use it to shave my face. And then I use this. This is the La Roche-Posay Purifying Foaming Cleanser for normal to oily skin. This is just definitely like a really like holy grail type of cleanser because it's really good. I used to use is it the same one? No, I used to use this one. I still have some in this.
I should have used this as a double cleanser. This is a hydrating gentle cleanser, and it just wasn't enough for my skin. This is also for the normal to dry skin. It just wasn't enough for me. But yeah, and then this is my lip scrub that I use. I'm really sorry if you guys hear my TV in the other room, but this is a lip scrub and it's finished, but I still got one more use. I have to take off my lip gloss, but it's still got some. I think this will be my last use. But I bought this like 2 years ago from this black owned business. I don't know if you guys can see it. Oh good, you can see it. And I don't know if the business is still open, but I have been using this and I love it because I think it just exfoliates my lips very well. And then I use one of these, but like to cleanse, but I'm gonna use a different one, you know, when I need to throw it out, I'm gonna throw it out. I use a new one. You put it under water and then it, what do you call this? I don't know, gets like bigger. So I'm going to use this. Use my dumper cleanser. Scrub it in. Scrub it in. Scrub it in. I think this is more of like a gentle cleanser. Let's see if I can get up close and personal and show you guys me taking off. I literally don't have a lot. I usually sometimes, you know, like to take off my sideburns because I have a lot of hair. It's not the most satisfying because I don't have like a lot of hair to take off, but I just wanted to show you guys my what I do because it really helps the makeup. I don't put on foundation, but I do put on powder, and I can tell like the powder just goes on a lot smoother. Let me know down in the comments what you guys' self-care routine is, maintenance routine. If you guys like do like to do the DIY stuff, I'm just gonna rinse my face, cold water, cold water, cold water. Now I'm gonna go in with my regular cleanser, but I'm gonna use the cleanser. This is my like real cleanser. I'm gonna take off the things. But remember to like at least cleanse your face for maybe a minute. Sometimes you don't have a minute in the morning, I understand. You know, at least 30 seconds. Remember to rinse with cold water or at least lukewarm. Don't rinse with hot water. I'm gonna just, oh, let me take this off. So I don't know, I think it'd be doing something. For my teeth care, if you guys are interested, I go in with the, you know, the TikTok famous. This really controls my, if I have bad breath in the morning. Use dental floss, make sure you're flossing. I use a spin brush. Sorry, there's a lot of toothpaste on it. But I use a spin brush thing. And then I use this Marvis whitening toothpaste. I think it also helps with like brightening my teeth. And then if you're using a lot of teeth whitening stuff, make sure you use Sensodyne Pro Enamel. And then I have a water pick. Dental hygiene is very important. I just wet my finger so that still does the job. I think I have one more use. I don't know what this business put in it, but it's really sweet. I'm assuming it's sugar. And then I just wipe it off. But that is what I do for my like dental stuff. But that's finished. That's what I do for my face. Took out my whitening thing for my teeth. My eyebrows are finished. I did my eyelashes. My face feels very clean, smooth. About to like moisturize it. But after that, I'm gonna get into doing my nails. I do my own nails. But now it's time for nails. Okay guys, so I pulled out everything that I need to use to do my fill-in. Woo! So I'm gonna show you guys what I have. So I have the Dappin' Dish. I have the Protein Bond by Young Nails. The Cover Pink that I use, it's that color. The liquid, I have two bottles of the monomer. And I have the nail swipe that I use. I showed you guys the no lint wipes that I have. I have quite quite a few, so this is probably gonna last me a while. I have a duster. I gotta use this duster just to, like, you know, dust this off. I have a Young Nails file. You can't really see it because it's like really, really faded. Well, not file. This is a buffer. And then I'm gonna have this file. And then this is, I'm gonna show you guys my brush that I use. This is a really good brush and I really like it. This is the Young Nail brush that I use. A little crooked, but still gets the job done. Right now I'm gonna file my nails. I'm going to put on Love Island and start doing my nails. Alright guys, so I am putting on Love Island and starting to file my nails. I really hate filing my nails. Filing my nails is the worst part about doing a fill-in or like doing a full set on myself. The dust is just so annoying. Okay guys, so all of my nails have been filed. My fingers look like they're dead. They're very dry right now. But I have cleaned up my area, filed my nails, and now I'm just going to use this to cut my cuticles. I've pushed them back already. I'm just cutting off the excess cuticle. One thing about me, I be having dry cuticles all year round. It's not even like during winter. It's like all the time. Some people say you're not supposed to cut this part, but I do. Because I'm not doing a full set, I don't need to file that much, which is why I like doing fill-ins on myself, because they don't take long. So now I'm gonna take the no white thing. I take two because I think just one is too thin to put the swipe on. I'm going to put the swipe on now. I feel like it dehydrates the nail, but also I need all the dust away, because dust and acrylic, it can cause lifting, I feel. So I am just making sure that I'm taking all the dust out. I think my nails last a long time because I do all these steps. But the next thing I showed you guys, I'm using the Protein Bond by Young Nails. And this thing is really, really good. It just does it for me. It helps the acrylic adhere to my natural nail. And I do two coats. I've used other brands, but Young Nails brand is really good. But yeah, I'm sitting here watching Love Island. And I want to know what y'all think about Ty and Ella. I'm using two cotton rounds to clean up the mess with the acrylic. And I am ready for application. Fun fact about me, I love this smell. Listen, I love the nail salon smell. I don't know if it's like an addictive thing. I'm gonna show you guys two applications of my nails and then I'm gonna come back.
So my battery died, guys. It's charging now, but with the acrylic, it's like I can't wait for my battery to charge to show you guys. But I'm gonna show you guys one more time. I don't know what the video captured, but I put the thing in the brush in the monomer. Make sure there's no bubbles. Saturate that thing. Saturate that brush. Good saturation. It's all wet and whatnot. And then this is really hard to show you, but you dab one. I kind of drag, but kind of tap, and then put the acrylic on my nail. And it's not too wet, not too dry. And then dab one more time. I freaking love when I have to do a fill-in because I don't really have to do much. Foundation is already there. Another tip that I do not put the acrylic too close to the cuticle. And I think that is the key to making sure that your nails stay on. I did these two nails already. That's just application. And we're gonna go through all 10 nails. And hopefully my camera battery charges so I can show you guys my design that I do. But basically the only next step is lay the acrylic, file, which I hate. I hate filing. When you're laying the acrylic, when you pick it up out the powder, we pick up the powder, wait for the acrylic bead to just wait a little, like just a little bit. Sometimes I don't wait, but it really just helps the acrylic just lay and all of the powder will, like, you know, turn into a good consistency. So you just wait a little bit, pick up your bead, wait just a little bit, depending on the size of the bead, and lay it on your nail. But I'm gonna quickly finish all 10 nails and come back and show you guys the design.
All right guys, we are back on my camera. I got my juice I finished filing and buffing my nails. My nails are definitely finito. This is my right hand. The right hand is always worse than the left, so don't judge me. So I'm gonna just show y'all the left hand. Yeah, I'm excited because this part is the painting. So I've got, what's new here is my lamp that I've had forever. But you know how y'all hear that your nails, your hand can get skin cancer? Listen, girlies, some dermatologists on TikTok, but they said when you about to do your gel, I do a lot of the gel, so I have to put on, you know, as much protection as I can. I've got my top coat, and it's by Maya Secret. This gel polish from Amazon, and then this is actually Alexandra's. It's a gel art brush from Beatles. I think everybody knows this one from Amazon. And then, like I said, I've got my swipe, and I've got the no lint wipes, and then I've got my UV. And what I'm gonna do is put on this pink. I'm gonna put on this pink color. It's very like nude. So, not nude, it's pink, but it gives the French a pink, you know, tone. So I'm gonna do that real quick. I think painting my nails is my favorite part. I love doing my fill-ins, but the final process of me getting like the fresh coat of paint on my nails and the gel, and it looks so shiny. I love this part. It's my favorite part. Also, guys, let me know down in the comments, what's your favorite self-care thing to do? I know nails is like my thing, but I want to know what your guys' favorite self-care thing to do is. Okay, guys, it's the fun part now. I would love to leave it like this because this is so cute, but I think it's like so plain. I just can't. Okay, but here, it really helps to do the nail art with a brush. If you do it with the regular nail polish, it's just not gonna work. So what I do, I'm gonna show y'all once and that's it, because I really need to focus. So I put a triangle type thing, and what I'm gonna do is fill in the space with all the white, and then that's gonna be French. The only thing about French is it's a lot of concentration, and if you mess up, you mess up. I like a deep like C curve, and that's like sometimes hard to achieve because you gotta really like practice. And as you guys can see, I messed up, but this is like the start of it. So I make the line go deeper, like all the way down, and then I curve it. I usually like it a little skinnier. I don't know, I don't like the bulky French. This is not coming out how I want. I can't. No, I'm starting over. Do over. All right, anyway, it's like a triangle type thing, and then I fill it in. That's how I do my French.
When y'all are doing like a French, what I do is, like I said, I take the nail art brush and put it all the way down in the cuticle, if that makes sense, and curve it, make a triangle, and then curve it. That really helps me. And I also move my finger along with the brush, so I'm not just relying on just the brush to paint.
It's still a little bulky for me, but that's fine. It's a-okay. And then cleaning up, I usually have like a brush to clean up, but I don't feel like getting it. I'm lazy today. But yeah, I'm gonna finish the rest of my nails and be done.
Also, guys, let me know if you guys are watching Love Island on Netflix. I really liked the season with Ty and Ella, the UK one, not the USA one. And let me know what y'all think about their relationship. A lot of people have been saying that they're the toxic relationship. So, guys, right here, I am just wiping the sidewalls of my nails so that the gel polish doesn't get too bulky when I put it under the lamp and cure it. That's one of the things I do so that my nails can stay like the square shape. I noticed that when I would put like gel polish on, it would get bulky, and I didn't like that look.
This hand turned out pretty good.
Okay, the last part.
The top coat.
This is the final step, the top coat. I really love doing the top coat step because it gets so shiny and it's the final step of doing your nails. I'm not gonna lie, doing your nails takes a while. Oh,
this is definitely going to be a lot of editing.
Last step is taking the file and I'm just filing my sidewalls. Okay, last step is I'm gonna take the swipe. This is like the most satisfying part. I'm gonna take the swipe and swipe the nails. Oh, I need to dust my nails too. And now take my cuticle oil so that my cuticles are not dry. So I can show you guys the last part. Alright, I gotta wash my hands and I'm gonna come back. So I wanna show you guys the finished product. My nails. Woo-hoo. This is my left hand and obviously this hand is the better hand. I did a phenomenal job in my eyes. It gets the job done and I think I did a pretty darn good job for it being me. I have done acrylics like when I was younger, so I have some experience. I don't always do acrylics and I don't always do my acrylics. So this hand is the right hand and it's got character. It looked good. I did it, got the job done, and my nails look beautiful. I honestly do not want to do my toes because I'm tired. I probably will do them tomorrow, but I'm not going to show you guys. I'm about to clean up, call it a day. So guys, as I'm editing this video, please excuse my appearance. But I just realized that I didn't really have a good transition or tell you guys I was going to get my wax. But I didn't say it in the video, but I'm at my wax appointment in this next clip.
I'm here, guys. It's so cute in here. It was so nice, but I'm about to get undressed and get my wax.
Alright guys, so I am officially done with doing all of my maintenance. You guys saw me. I finished getting my hair done. I did my own lashes, did my own nails. I did my skincare. I showed you guys how I do my skincare maintenance stuff. And what else did I show you guys? I did show you guys my nails. What else? Eyelashes, eyebrows. I think that's it. I tried to bring you guys along the way to do my wax, but that didn't end up like playing out how I wanted it. I just showed you guys like the inside of like my wax room, and then I was finished getting my wax done because I was like a little like anxious about getting my wax because I haven't gotten wax in a long time. I just wanted to just get my wax and, you know, not film or anything. It was actually very it wasn't painful. It wasn't like European wax center. I've gotten my waxes done with them before and they use hard wax, and it just really 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 hurts, especially if you're going for your first time. But this was my first time getting sugared at I think it's called Sugared NYC. And it was literally, I would like to classify it as painless, but it was less painful than getting hard wax. They use sugar, and she only used like 2 balls of sugar and just kept waxing. And my waxer, she was pretty fast with it, and she also was like pressing down as soon as she when she ripped the wax off, she pressed it really quickly, so I didn't have time to really feel any of it, just the initial like rip. But it was really like, it was not bad. So I definitely would recommend getting sugared instead of using the hard wax. But I just wanted to come on here and close out my vlog. I want to say thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye guys.